Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, Sweet Art Crafts. In this video, I wanted to show you guys how I made some of these Valentine's Day inspired keychains. I know I'm uploading this a day after Valentine's Day because I usually have my sales on Saturday, so I wanted to make sure I had all these keychains up at the same time as this video. And this video is not really a tutorial type of video, it's more like a watch me resin, but I do show you how to do a couple of different things that I haven't shown before. Before getting into the rest of this video, I just wanted to make sure you guys know the epoxy resin safety. Make sure that you are wearing nitrile gloves and are working in a well-ventilated room with windows open, or preferably a garage or a porch. And also make sure you're wearing a respiratory mask, specifically one that filters out vapors like the mask that I'm showing here. This is my brand new mask and I've been loving it so far. So yeah. Here are some of the supplies that I will be using in this video. I didn't show everything that I used in these clips, but I will make sure to link them linked down below. And here are some of the beads that I sell on my website, so click the link down below. And the resin that I'll be using is actually two different ones. I'll be using Art and Glow and Liquid Diamonds. I like using both of these for two different things, so yeah. For the charms in the next few clips, I just added some mica pigments to the Art and Glow resin, and now I'm just adding some gold flakes, and that's pretty much it. And then I'll be pouring them into the molds. And all of the molds that are shown in this video, except for the Pikachu one, are all sold on my website. I make all of these and I design them. So yeah, so if you're interested in purchasing my molds, make sure to click my website link in the description box. And the Pikachu mold is from Amazon, I believe. So I'll make sure to also link that down below as well. Now I'm going to be using my new BTS heart shaker molds, and I'm going to be painting them. Somebody on Instagram asked me if I could show how I paint my molds for these, and I already have a whole dedicated video showing you guys how I paint my molds and paint my charms, and but I'm just going to show you guys quickly how I do it. So basically I just use acrylic paint and these dotting tools, and I'm just going to paint onto the molds, and then I allow them to dry for maybe 20 to 30 minutes before pouring in resin, because if you don't, they will get really, really messy. Like when you're doing molding, like it will just be all patchy and stuff like that, because even when the resin is poured onto it and curing, the paint just doesn't fully dry. Like it's happened to me before and it's a mess. So that's why I recommend you waiting at least 20 to 30 minutes before pouring resin into the painted mold. For these charms, I'm going to be using Liquid Diamonds resin, and I'm going to be adding some rose leaves. I actually dried this flower myself, and I didn't film how I did it, but if you guys are interested in me having a video on how I dry my flowers for resin, I'll definitely make one, so just leave a comment if you're interested in that. And now I'm just adding gold flakes into the resin as well, and then I'll add some pigments. And the reason why I really like using Liquid Diamonds for this particular these particular charms is because since it's mostly clear, there's no color added into this set, the Liquid Diamonds has less micro bubbles than the Art and Glow, so this is why I like to use it for charms that I would like to have very clear, so that you don't see the bubbles or anything like that. For these charms as well, I'm going to be using liquid diamonds because I want the rim to be very clear, and I'm going to be using this heart glitter that I got from Michael's, I believe. I'm not sure if they still sell it, but yeah. So basically what I'm doing is adding each of these heart glitters individually into the resin. So I just take a toothpick and I wet it with some resin, and then I just start taking the toothpick and picking up some glitter, heart glitter, and then I'm placing it into the molds. And this took me so long. I'm just like, I kind of regret doing it, but they came out super cute, but it took me forever to place every single heart glitter. I already know I'm going to get a few questions on how I got this effect on these charms, and I actually have a video showing how I did it in my previous video, and it's basically called Fluid Art with Resin or Dirty Pour. And yeah, just click the I card above to get a full in-depth video on how to do it. So for these Pikachus, I'm making them iridescent, and I do have a full tutorial showing you how to make these holographic slash iridescent pieces, but I'm just showing you a little overview of how I make them. But yeah, click the iCard above on how I make these. So here I'm just showing you basically how I prep my molds for their second layer. So this is after a few hours of letting the resin cure, and then I go ahead and put on the backing layers. I just remove any resin that's lingering on the shaker portion, and just pouring on the backing, and yeah. For these two candy heart molds, I actually like to wait until after I have poured the resin and let them cure to paint the charms, just because they are very small, like lettering. So usually if I try to paint the mold, everything gets blurred together and it's easier for me to make mistakes. So that's why I like to paint it afterwards, which I will be showing you later on in this video. But I'm just mixing up my resin colors and pouring them into the mold. Now that it's been 24 hours and most of the resin charms are fully cured, I'm going to start painting the Pikachu ears, and I like to do two layers, and I'm just using regular acrylic paint. Now I'm going to show you how I paint these candy hearts, and basically I'm just going to use acrylic paint and a toothpick, and I'm going to apply it to the candy hearts, and I allow them to dry for just maybe like 5 to 10 minutes. And then I'm going to take my finger and just with a glove, and I'm going to just wipe off the paint around it. It's just easier this way than using like alcohol or a wipe, because usually I'll wipe off the words with these small little charms. So that's why I like to do it that way. The majority of the rest of this video, I'm just showing you guys the process of me filling my shaker charms with their pieces, their shaker pieces, and then I'm going to show the afterwards of after I put the transparency film and UV resin. This video I didn't really show in depth of how I make my shaker charms, because I already have a full dedicated video on how I do that, so click the iCard above to go to that video. I just can't show everything that I do, just because this video would probably be an hour long, and I know people would not like to watch an hour long video of me talking about the same thing over and over again. So yeah, that's why I just really cut it short and mostly just show you me filling in my pieces, because it's always different on most of the time of the different stuff that I add into my shaker charms. Now I'm going to be taking some 91% rubbing alcohol and pouring it onto a paper towel to clean down the surface of my charms. I used to use antibacterial wipes to do this, and it was causing like these weird dips in the resin when I'm was doming. So someone suggested that I use rubbing alcohol. So if you were that person, leave a comment so I can pin it you to the top. But yeah, I'm basically just doming my charms. And I do have a video showing my whole process of how I dome my resin charms and using liquid latex and all that. So make sure to click the I card above. So after 24 hours after doming the resin charms, this is how they turned out. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, even though it was more of a watch me resin than a tutorial. So make sure that you are subscribed, like this video, comment down below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye now!